2001 sort of set the style for the modern age of space movies. Yeah. Aliens sort of roughed it up a little bit. What did you think when you're going into this movie? How can I make it different? Did you know from the beginning it would be the sun?
Yeah, we had this. That was always the idea of this journey to the sun, and we had all these ambitions to make it really different, you know. And it's an amazing discipline to work in, because you. Like, one example is, I was like absolutely adamant. I hate starfields, you know, in movies. You know, little twinkling lights, those endless twinkling lights. And I was like this. There's no way we're having a starfield. Because when you're in space, if you're, you know, looking at the sun or the brightest star, you can't see anything else. It's just black. Because it's just simply the brightest object. So I said, that's completely unreal. All movies have just not done it properly, and I'm going to do it properly, and it's going to be velvety black, pitch black, like the black you've never seen before, which will suggest the eternity of space, etc.
And you get the right cinematographer, and you can do this.
And we get the right cinematographer who can do this. I thought, that's great. And of course, as soon as you put the spaceship in this black space, it looks like it's stopped, you know? And everybody goes, why is the spaceship stopped? Why did they stop? Is something gone wrong?
No rocket flames or anything.
Because the only way that, and that's why this starfield is there in every movie you see, it's because the only way that you can suggest motion is to have a starfield for it to move across. And that's, so it's not because George Lucas or Stanley Kubrick like starfields, it's because you have to have them. And it's full of pitfalls like that, this genre, where you have to do it in a certain way. Like another one is weightlessness, which is, if you look at them in the space station, the weightlessness, they are weightless, but they're also, they look quite jerky. The way they move, and that's because they're actually moving in real time, is that things happen there. If you clap your hands in space, you do it like that. If you do it in a movie, it looks wrong, and they don't look weightless, because the convention is you have to do it in slow motion like that to suggest weightlessness. So you have to do weightlessness like that, and there's all these kind of rules like that you have to stick with. So it's a very
daunting.
It's actually like foot binding. It's like really kind of crippling. You have to you're forced into certain situations with it.
Must have been a terrible technical challenge to shoot the sun, was it not? Is that a giant sun you just made, or is it all CGI?
A lot of it is based on the photographs from the SOHO project, which is this satellite that photographs the sun. And in fact, they just set up that trigonometry satellite where they photograph it to get the 3D image, so they get a better perspective on it. And a lot of the material is based on that. But I imagine that the reason that we couldn't really find a film that there'd really been about the sun. Or, I mean, in Lost in Space, they just fly through the sun. They go through it and go, whew, that was hot. And then they carry on with their adventures after that. But apart from that, we couldn't really find any films that had been about the sun. And I imagine it's because until CG became so as sophisticated as it is now, it's not been possible really to represent it. And that was the biggest challenge for us, to try and just represent it and also incrementally increase it as they get closer and closer to it, its power.
Could you go on and do another sci-fi movie, another space movie? Did you get ideas working on this one and think, gee, you know, I could do this too?
No, I thought that's it.
Right?
I would never, ever, ever do another space movie. And it's just extraordinary. There's that great, I always thought it was Bertolucci said about you should always have a door open on your film set for real life to walk in. In fact, it's not, it's Renoir said it, and Bertolucci borrowed it from him. But on a space movie, that door has to be closed, because otherwise the ship would depressurize and all life would be lost, you know. But you are in a sealed, you know, you don't get any of that free accident that you get from real life. And so they're a huge challenge to you. And you have to create everything, you know. It's like a sealed unit. There's no outside life in it at all. Yeah.